Now next, parallel forces. Okay, so these are the classification of forces. Now let us understand what is coplanar forces. So coplanar forces, when the force are acting on the same plane. So here there is an x, y and z. When all the forces are acting on a same plane, then we call it is a coplanar forces. Suppose the number of forces are acting on the same plane, or irrespective of their directions and their nature, but all the forces are acting on any one plane, either this plane or this plane or this plane. Okay, such type of forces we call as it is a coplanar forces. Non-coplanar. So non-coplanar, when all the forces are at a different planes. These are the planes: plane 1, plane 2, plane 3. So where forces are acting at a different planes. There is a one plane from the second plane and one force from the third plane. So number of forces are acting from the different planes, that we call as the it is a coplanar forces. Okay, different places we call as non-coplanar. All the forces are acting in the same way, we call as coplanar forces. Now coming to the concurrent. Okay, so concurrent, as the name itself, concurrent means meet at a point. It means all the forces are meeting at a point. The best example I can say here, so there is an echo problem due to this room. Okay, so and I forget my mic. Maybe there is a problem with my sound also, my audio problem. Okay, so let us adjust today. Concurrent forces. So concurrent forces, the number of forces are acting and meeting at a one point. So this is the point where all the forces are producing or they are meeting at a one point. So it may be any direction, it may be tensile or it may be the compression. So this point, all the forces are meeting or exclusion from this point, or they are meeting to this point. They are meeting at this point, we call as concurrent forces. Hope it is clear to you. There may be explosion or they may be meeting at a one point. Such type of forces we call as it is an concurrent forces. Now coming to this collinear. Okay, so collinear, when all the forces are passing through a single line, they are moving in a single line. Collinear. Linear is nothing but it is a one dimensional, one element. So there is a one force, it is moving in the same axis, second force and third force. So there are different forces, F1, F2 and F3. So all three forces are moving on the same axis. They are moving the line of contact or line of passing through a single line. Such type of forces we call as collinear forces. Okay, so collinear forces moving in the same path, coplanar acting on the same plane, and concurrent meeting at the same point or explosion from the same point, such type of forces we call. Then the last one, that is parallel. As you can understand the meaning of parallel, so number of forces are parallel to each other. So this is the force 1, force 2, force 3. Okay, so these are all parallel forces. Another, there will be one more type, non-parallel. Okay, when the forces are acting. Suppose these forces, the system of forces, it may be concurrent but non-parallel, right? So that is a non-parallel. There are different forces but acting in the same plane but non-parallel. Another, in the parallel we can again divide. See, suppose all the forces are moving in the same direction. When all the forces are moving in the same direction, such type of forces we call as like parallel. Like parallel. So when all the forces having the same direction, such type of forces we call as like parallel. There is another one more type in the parallel. When the forces are moving with different directions, they are parallel. Okay, hope is it clear to you?
That board. Okay, now you can see.
So all these forces are parallel, but the direction is different. One force is moving towards right side, another force is moving towards left side. Okay, any one force will travel the opposite direction, then we can say this is an that like and this is an unlike. Unlike parallel forces. So one is like parallel, another is unlike parallel forces. Okay, so these are the just basic introduction of types of forces. In that we have mainly classification: coplanar, concurrent, collinear, and parallel. So in the coplanar, all the forces are meeting, all the forces are acting in the single plane. You can use the word single plane. Here you can say single plane. Single plane. And in the concurrent, so concurrent is nothing but meeting at one point or one dot. All the forces are meeting, is irrespective of their direction, but they are meeting at a single point. So type of forces we call as concurrent. Another is collinear. Linear is nothing but there is a line, but all the forces are passing. Passing through same line. Another one is parallel force. When all the forces are parallel to each other and they are moving in the same direction, then we call as like parallel. If they are moving in a different direction, then we call as unlike parallel forces. Right? Hope it is clear to you.
Now again we'll go to the
so what do you mean by equilibrium? Second, so the equilibrium, it is nothing but the action of given force system is rigidly in a way changes. And if we add and if we subtract from them to another system of forces, then we call as it is in equilibrium forces. For example, if there are a rope, when two guys are pulling the rope from one end, and in the left, right side also, two forces are acting, or two guys are acting. Okay, suppose if the person one 5 kilo load, 9% to 5 kilo or 5 newton meters, and second here 5. So in the right side and left side, both are in equilibrium. Total 10 newton and 10 newton forces are applied. It means it is in the equilibrium condition. Suppose one per person is applying a load of 6 newton, and now the body, it is in unequilibrium conditions. Okay, so this is called the making of equilibrium conditions. Now we go to the another topic, that is resolution of forces. Resolution of forces. So what do you mean by resolution? It is the resolution of forces. So now if you are having a body, and then the number of forces are acting on the body. Now you have to resolve these forces into the equilibrium conditions. Okay. So here it is the method. How can you define here? It is the method of resolving. This is the method of resolving or splitting the single forces into perpendicular direction into two perpendicular direction is called resolution of forces. Okay. It is the method of resolving or splitting the single force into two perpendicular direction is called resolution of forces. Okay, so what do you mean? When there is a one force is acting, suppose let us say there is a one force is acting from the one point. Okay, so the single force we can resolve to the vertical. When you resolve these forces to the vertical, it has some angle. Okay. So this is a force and this is a theta, the angle which will produce. So this force we can make resolve to the vertical also. So here it will be F sine theta when you resolve vertically. Same force you can resolve to the horizontal also, then it will be F cos theta. The same force resolving vertically and resolving horizontally, you will get two resolutions. So such method we called as resolution of forces, and this is very important to solve the problems in our first unit. Okay, now we will have the one simple problems on resolution of forces. Okay, let us take the example here. There is one force and second force. This is third force and fourth force. Let us say this is F1, F2, F3, F4 for the example point. I am indicating this one. Okay. Now we need to resolve these forces. Again, if you want, you can make one more diagonal force. It is F5. Okay.
So different forces are acting on the
square. Now, how we can dissolve these forces? Now, let us say dissolving all the forces horizontally. First, we will say dissolving forces horizontally. So, all the forces to be dissolved horizontally. So, we will start with F1, where F1 is acting upward direction. F1 is acting upward direction. It means the zero. It cannot make these forces to the horizontal. Now, F1, you can take cos 90 degrees, then it will be 1. Similarly, sorry, it will be 0. F2, F2 is resolving horizontally towards right side. The direction is towards right. So, first you have to understand the direction. Towards right is positive, towards left is negative. Upward is positive and downward is negative.
As a quadratic system, it is to be understood.
Okay. F2 acting towards right side. So, plus F2. F2 is plus towards this side. Again, this is a vertical force, it will get 0. And next, there is a horizontal force, F4, towards left side. So, minus F4. Minus F4. And all these forces are completed. Now there is our diagonal forces. So this F5, if we resolve horizontally, or you can make resolving horizontally. So F5, if you resolve horizontally, theta. Let us say theta. So F5 cos theta towards the direction it will be towards left side. So it will be minus F5 cos theta. Is equal to 0.
Hope it is clear to you. Now, similarly, resolving all the forces vertically.
You have to make the resolving all the forces vertically. So, F1, it is acting upward action. So, upward, it is plus. Plus, F1. Another force, F2, it will be 0. F3, downward acting. Force is downward, so minus. F3. Another horizontal will get 0. There is one more force, diagonal force. So when if you resolve this force vertically, there is a theta. So F5, sine minus. Minus because when you dissolve these forces, the direction of the forces will come towards the down. So minus F5 sine theta is equal to 0.
Hope it is clear to you how you can dissolve horizontally and vertically. So if you are still in confusion, then we'll take the another problem. Okay, simple problem I will write here.
So, let us draw a simple problem. These are the coordinates. So, here number of forces are acting.
Okay, so randomly all the values are selected. Now you can see how the forces can be resolved. First, resolve all the forces horizontally. Let us write horizontally. You can resolve it.
Okay, so we'll start with the force of 10 newton. So this 10 newton, when you resolve horizontally, so same force if you resolve horizontally, so the direction it is towards the left side, and angle it is making 30 degree. So minus 30. Okay, so minus 10 cos 30 degree. Direction towards left, therefore minus 10, and angle is 30 degree. When it comes to this side, 5 newton, this force dissolving towards right side. So 5 cos 10 degree, horizontally cos. Another force, 12 newton, when you this 12 newton, if you dissolve horizontally, so the angle is 60 degree. So 12 cos 60 degree. And what will be the direction of this force when you resolve towards this side? Direction towards same force, you just make into this direction. So force 12, the direction is towards right. So 12 cos 60 degree. And another force 30, when you resolve these forces to horizontal. Okay, so it is away axis, the angle is away axis. So whatever the remaining angle here, so what will be the remaining angle? 90 minus 5 equals 85. This angle will be 85, right? So 30 degree, when you resolve horizontally, 30 cos 85 degree, and direction is minus because it is towards the left side, minus 30 cos 85 degree is equal to 0.
We can check now once again. Okay, so now we resolve all the forces vertically.
Now you can try by resolving all the forces vertically. So first force, again this 10 newton, if you resolve vertically, so 10 newton with an angle of 30 degree. Okay, so you have to resolve these forces vertically. So it is again the 30 degrees away from the angle. So you are resolving like this. So 90 minus 30, so we have 60 degree. So 10 sin 60 degree plus upward is plus 10 sin 60 degree. Another force, 5 newton is acting at an angle of 80 degree. 5 sin 80 degree plus 5 sin 80 degree. Another force, 12. What is the angle here? It is given as 60, it means 30 degree. 12 sin 30 degree. Sin, it will be minus. Minus 12 sin 30 degree. Another force, 30. Here it is given as 5. It means 30 sin 5 degree. Plus 30 sin 5 degree. Degree is equal to 0.
Now you can check once again.
So now I request for their roll number, so that will be considered as your attendance. Okay, now in the comment box you can support number, I will take the attendance shortly. So you can make the note of this. Okay, so this is just introduction. Section. So here with some basic problem we have discussed it. Okay. So now I request everyone to post your roll number in the comment box.
And also you can come suggest about the classes. You can give the feedback
for any improvement. And today I have forget about my collar mic, otherwise the audio quality would be good. Okay, so and also there is a problem with the room because it is a closed room, so there may be some echo problem here. Okay, so guys, thank you for more on online and making the better utilization of the class.
Yes, anyone, if you want, you can make comments here. If you are having any doubts, yes, if you are facing any doubts, you can make me in the comment box. So that I will be live for another. Okay, guys, I'm going to close this session. We'll meet.